Ali, at the time, the only minister who could speak French. And I got on well with the French ambassador. And on one occasion he asked me that he had recommended me to the French government for the award of what they called Chevalier. And that meant I was a knight, and you had a small button for that one. Now, I felt I was going too fast, and some of my colleagues, I was foreign minister, and on another occasion I was development minister, and some of my colleagues were getting a bit jealous. So I mentioned the suggestion to the president. I said, Shaki, the French ambassador, since he's recommended me for the order of Chevalier, and I don't know whether I should take it. He said, oh yes, yes, so no, you can take it. But the way in which he said it made me realize that he was not quite happy that I should have that honor whilst he didn't get it. So I turned it down, and I do regret having turned down that Chevalier, because I afterwards had so many contacts in France, and it would have helped me to be pinning that little button on my lapel that I am one of the Chevaliers. When I came from Geneva, when I went home in 1959, I had a recorder. I think, Elizabethan, like that. And it recorded on a wheel with a sort of electronic ribbon. So an aunt came, an old lady, and we were talking, and she was saying, oh, how wonderful, you come back from Geneva, this and that. And after about 5 minutes, I said, Aunty Phebian, I want to play something for you. And I reached on the real ground and pressed, and she had herself talking for the past 5 minutes, all those things. He said, no, I'm not coming here again. I wouldn't come here. You have something which will be getting my voice. She was so surprised to hear of what she was saying, yeah. You know, played back to her. Yeah. She had never heard anything about that before. And she said, no, I've got it was a devil or something like that. She wouldn't come again, or if she comes, she would not be talking at all, because the devil in that box will be taking a voice.
Political achievement, what would you say is your highest political achievement?
I don't like to think. Oh, it's difficult.
A landmark achievement.
Yes, it's difficult. It's
that
difficult,
you did that in the different ministries.
In politics, it is a question of up and down. And I would say that my highest achievement was in America.
Okay.
It was at the time of Secretary of State.
Kissinger.
Huh?
Is it Kissinger?
No, it wasn't Kissinger. It was before Kissinger. It was before Kissinger. It's in the book there. What happened was, I don't remember, our party was in power and was suffering all sorts of reverses. Uprisings here, riots there, and that type of thing. And the boys, the small boys of the party, including a friend who died about 2 years ago. You remember Adewale?
Yes.
Yeah, he was one of them. And and a cousin of mine called I think the name will come. They were she was young at the time. They were leading these young APC boys. And they said America was at the back of it. America felt that Siaka Stevens was communist, that he was leaning more with the communist part of the world, and that type of thing. So you know what they did? They went to the American embassy in force, singing and chanting, climbed up the flagpole, bought the stars and stripes, or stripes and stars, whatever it is, down, poured petrol on it, burnt it, and the whatever was left of it, they were dragging it around the streets. Well, that's the worst thing you can do to America. So straight away, America recalled her ambassador. Straight away, we were in the black books of America, and for a small developing country to be in the black books in those days of America was something to be reckoned with. Everything we had to do, America was no. America stopped all aid to Sierra Leone. And the friends of America followed suit. It was necessary that we were feeling the pinch, and the president realized that something had to be done to pacify America and palliate. He chose me to go to America with one objective: to resume cordial relationships. I went. Then this man was at the ambassador. Pama. He is now in the States. Philip Pama. Mm-hmm. He was the ambassador in Washington. I went to Philip and told him that I had been assigned this job to do, and can he fix an appointment for me to get George, what was the name? Anyway, you'll find the name of the Secretary of State to get him to resume relations. And Philip said, since the flag burning incident, I have not been invited to go to the White House. They've forgotten that as there was an ambassador from Sierra Leone. Well, I said, well, I've been sent that you should do something about it. He told them I was there in Washington, and he asked for an appointment. And a note verbal, and that's what they called it, a note verbal issued from the Washington office for the Secretary of State. Wasn't it called Rogers? The name is for me, but it was before Kissinger. To say, sorry, the Secretary had many engagements and could not see me. But if I didn't mind, he would ask me to meet with one of his officers. I agreed.
Well, and
the appointment or whatever it is was confirmed, and I was given a date to go to the White House, date and time. It was to meet with one of the most junior officers in the Foreign Department of the White House. I went, And I looked at the fellow. He looked at me. But of course, there was diplomatic protocol to be observed. He was a fellow who had been working in Geneva in what was known as WFUNA, World Federation of United Nations Association. And he was the head. And I used to be assisting him. I was in the ILO, and when I finished work, I would go over there, help him doing this and that. And I was in their committee and that type of thing. He was called Robert Smith. He looked at me and I looked at him. And of course, there was this diplomatic protocol. And I said, I came to explain what had happened about the burning of the American flag, that the culprits have all been arrested and dealt with in courts, you know, that type of thing. That the president regrets the incidents, all diplomatic language. He had some officers with him and people taking down. In those days, it was, they took information down in shorthand. There were the secretaries and other people. And I went on and on like that, saying we regret and we're sorry, it would not happen again. And then he couldn't restrain himself anymore. He said, Solomon. And I said, Robert. And he got up and embraced me. He embraced me. And he drew me near to sit by him. And we started talking about Geneva days. Forgot completely what my mission was, and what happened after I had left, what and what he did, how he managed to get his job in the American Secretary of State's office from WFUNA. And we went on like that for something like about half an hour. Forgot completely. So in the end I said, well, Robert, I congratulate you. This is very good. Actually, he was very junior. He'd just been appointed. So I said, I do congratulate you, but please explain to Secretary, I think that man was Rogers. Please explain to Secretary Rogers that this had nothing at all to do with the government. It is true that it was the youngsters in the parties who did it, but they were not under the control of the government and we didn't even approve of what they did. So let Secretary Rogers know this and that type of thing. Say, you don't worry, you know, I'll explain to him. Okay. We have finished, got back to our own embassy. Within a day or two, there was a note verbal to the ambassador inviting me and the ambassador to go to the White House to meet Secretary Rogers. And I went, and Robert Smith was there, and it was quite a cordial meeting, and Rogers said, well, they heard about this incident, they were unhappy, but I have already come, and his officer, pointing at Robert, has explained what I told him, and they're quite satisfied, and I can assure my president that the normal relations have been resumed. I think that's really one of the highest achievements which I had. Mm. It was so difficult to go to America on that assignment. Mm. But for the grace of God, meeting Robert Smith, if it was someone else, I don't think I would have succeeded. Mm. But it was Robert Smith, a very junior officer, who was to receive me, and Rogers didn't realize that both of us had crossed paths together and I had been assisting the Robert Smith in Geneva. So, in answer to your question, there are many other things, you know, you name it, but in the foreign office, I would say that was something which was difficult. It was difficult also for me to get recognition for China. America was backing the other China, whatever they call him, Chiang Kai-shek. And I had to maneuver and get China. It was the same with Germany. There were two Germanies, you know. Even after the war, there were two Germanies. You had the communists, the one by Russia, the other one by the West. And to get one Germany represented in Sierra Leone, it was a problem. But I managed that in the Foreign Office, as Foreign Minister, I think I handled all these situations. I practically solved each and every one of them. But the highest, I would say, was America and the burning of the flag.